Ma'am? Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
We can start our session, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Yeah, so we were discussing about how to configure, install, and how to add devices in BayWire simulator. So yesterday we added three devices, right? Proximity sensor, subscriber, and temperature sensor. Now, if you remember the IoT simulator and it's working, so we have three components there. So one is say a publisher, and we have an IoT platform, and we have a subscriber, right? So publisher publishes the data, so it will send to the platform, and platform will forward it to the specific subscriber if subscriber has subscribed to the topic, right? So this is how. Now what we have done so far is we have added a devices, we have created and we have configured the devices here. So that is two sensors and one subscriber. So here sensors acts like a publisher. So they'll be publishing your data to the IoT platform, and from the platform you will be forwarding to the subscriber, right? So now what we have to do is we have to connect these devices to the device manager, right? Or we have to connect these devices to the broker. Now if you go to settings, okay, so here we will come to know which is a broker we have selected. So we have selected BayWire's IoT platform, right? So its broker's IP address is given here. That is devicemanager.bayware.com. So you should go to this link. So go to this link. So here, say you will get a dashboard. Okay. So in order to configure, in order to manage and control those devices, right? So the broker settings is available in this particular link. So if you are a first time user, so you have to sign up, you have to create your account by filling the sign up form, created the account. So I'm logging in directly, right? So this is a dashboard. Okay, so here you have all the controls and commands in order to control and remotely configure these devices. Okay, so now how to view whether the device is up or not. Once say you have created a login, you go to the security. Okay, so you go to the security option here in the broker. So there you will get an authentication key and authorization key. Authorization and say authentication token signed keys. So this you have to add in the device, because the device should not publish to an unintended broker, right? So through this particular key, you're creating a separate session between the publisher and the broker so that the data should not be misled, okay? So now how to connect, say, this device to the broker? Now to do that, click on the device. You have an option here called as authentication. Okay, enable this authentication. So you have to enter two data here. One is the access key and access token. So access key and token are nothing but authentication key and authentication token here. Okay, so copy this authentication key and paste it in a place of access key. Click on save. Okay, now same way you copy this authentication token and paste it to the access token. Right, so now you have given authentication for a specific broker. So using this key and token, the sensor will connect to the broker, that particular broker. Same thing for all the devices. Now I have to give an authentication to the temperature sensor. Key. Paste it here. Same way, copy authentication token. Paste it here. Okay. So do the same thing for the subscriber also. So take authentication key. And provide the token. Okay. So now you have set the authentication for all the three devices. Right now, if these devices has to communicate to the broker, then you need to start the network. Okay, so now the network design is ready. The network has not yet started. It is not yet publishing the data. Okay, so to start the network, you can see this red button on the top right corner. Okay, so click on this button. So it will take some time. Okay, to start. Now you can see that the buttons from has turned from red to green, right? So it means that the network is running now and the devices are running. Okay, so if it turns to red, it means that something wrong and the devices is disconnected from the network. Okay, now your subscriber is connected to the publisher via IoT platform. Okay. Now you can see device log here. Now I click on the temperature sensor. You can see device log. This will give you information about what data, what time, okay, date, and what data it is publishing. Right now, if you see here 10:43:55, so it is publishing a data device temperature. Okay, level equals to 93. Right. So same way here it is publishing the message. See here you can see it is publishing the data using a JSON construct. So here it is a simple message. Okay, so that's how you can make out a difference between whether you are getting a data from using a JSON event or a message event. Then yesterday we created a connected event, right? Now we have three events here. One is sensor connect. So when the temperature sensor connects to the network, it will publish this message. Okay, so what is the message? Temperature sensor connected. When I started the network, the temperature sensor connected to the network, so it has published one data, that is temperature sensor connect. Temperature sensor disconnects, so it will print a it will publish a message, temperature sensor disconnect. Okay, so the remaining time after the whole day event, it will be publishing the temperature value as a range of 0 to 100, that every 15 seconds and every 20 seconds. Okay, so that is what you are getting a data here. If you double click on this, you can view what is the data published. So here 25 it is publishing, so here 7 it is publishing. Okay, so it will publish data, keep on publishing a data within a range of 0 to 100. Now what I do is I disconnect this device. I just click on this. Okay, I disconnected the device, okay, from the network. Now you can see it has published the message, temperature sensor disconnected. Okay, so you are receiving the message from all the four events which we have created here, right? So I'll turn on this device. Now, when I turn on this device, see, it has published a message, temperature sensor connected. Okay. So, similarly, you can see the device log for proximity sensor. Okay. So, here, what are the events we have created? We have created connected event, disconnect event, and also the metal detection event, right? So, three events we have created. So, the first event, when proximity sensor connected, so it is published sensor connected. Okay, and all other remaining data is the metallic detection data, right? Okay, so now coming to the subscriber. Okay, now what is the work of subscriber? One more thing, here you can see in subscriber also we have created a three events. One is connected, disconnected, and the data received. Okay, so here you can see two types of message here, right? So which is marked in orange color and which is marked in say green color, right? So the data which is marked in orange color, or the event which is marked in orange color, is related to the subscriber. Okay, so the event which is marked in green color here is related to the sensors, that is related to the publisher. Okay, so this is how you can make out a difference between whether the data received by the subscriber is from its own event or from the other devices or from the publisher. Okay, so here what is the command received? So say metal detect level 2. So it means that this is a data received by the subscriber from the proximity sensor. Okay, so because we have connected the both, right? We have connected to the proximity sensor and we have connected to the temperature sensor. So both the sensors will be publishing the data. Both the sensors will be publishing the data to the subscriber, right? So here you can see which sensor is currently publishing the data to the subscriber, right? So this is how to see the log. You can see the log, what data is published, okay, all these things within the simulator itself, right? Now coming to the broker settings here. Here in the broker settings also, you have a dashboard where you can see the data currently published. Okay, now see the metal detect level is an event which we have created for proximity sensor, right? So currently, the broker is receiving, data from the proximity sensor. So in between, you got an alert, right? We have created a behavior sensor for, the temperature and also the metal detection with the subscriber, right? Now, what is the behavioral event we have created? If proximity sensor is giving a data more than 5, then it should create an alert. What is the alert message? Danger metal alert is a message it should print. If the temperature sensor is giving a value greater than 50, then it should create an alert message that this temperature is high. Okay. So now you can see once the subscriber gets a data, okay, it will check for the behavioral event which you have designed. Now, if it is receiving a value more than 5 from the proximity sensor, then it will generate this alert. Okay, same way if it is if the subscriber is receiving a value more than 50 and more than 30 from the temperature sensor, then it will generate an alert. This particular temperature is high alert. Okay, so this is how you can also simulate the behavioral event. See here you can see a message danger metal alert because it has given a value more than 5. Okay, so like this, all the events, what data they are publishing, okay, so what alert the devices are giving, you can see in the broker dashboard. Okay, now coming to the devices option in the broker dashboard. So here you can see the list of all the devices connected. So previously I had created some simulation. Okay, out of that it is showing the device. So here you can see which device is active, which device is inactive, when they were up. Okay, all these details. I'll just go for an active device. Now currently we have 3 active devices. So here you can see the 3 active devices status. Right. So to know what is the status of a specific device, you can use this broker settings, right? Now, say coming to the report. Now, if you have to generate a report of what data published by a specific publisher, okay, so then you can generate. I'll go to the option, create graph. So give it as temperature graph, okay? So select the device. We have many devices. So look at what is a device ID of our temperature sensor in the simulation. So temp_s is a client ID. It's ID temp_s I'm selecting. So I have 2 topics. Okay, so for which topic I have to generate the graph, select that particular topic. Okay, so one is for a specific time and one is for the whole day. Two events have generated here. So I'll consider the whole day event and you can select the key, right? So topic is this and you can select the key and duration. Suppose you want a graph of data published within half an hour or within 1 hour or within 3 hours. Okay, so the log of data is already maintained and it is saved. If you remember in the broker setting, we had given clean session equals to zero, right? Here clean session equals to zero because whatever data published by the devices will be saved in the broker, right? So suppose if we give 1 year, then it will not save the data. When particular publisher disconnects, then all the data, all the log will be deleted. Okay, so that way we cannot generate or we cannot fetch the history data. So because we have given clean session is 0 year, so I can fetch all the previous data which is published by the publisher, specific publisher. Okay, so here I can say I'll give last half an hour data and click on create. So now you can see the graph of our data which is published. Now what is the advantage of this? So you can make out say on July 22nd, okay, from 5:13 to 5:22. Okay, so this is a timeline where the data is published. So at 5:13, you can see the temperature sensed is high. Okay, so then from 5:14 to 5:17, the temperature sensed is around 60. Right, so through this graph, you can make an analysis of a data. So you can use this for doing a further analysis and for doing further the predictive analysis of the data. Suppose you want to see in a particular week, okay, for a particular duration, what is the temperature, right? Based on that, you can do the prediction. Okay, so same way you can create a graph for proximity sensor also. So, proximity sensor graph. Then what is the device ID? Look at the device ID because we'll have a multiple devices listed there. So depending on your network connection, it takes some time to respond because there are so many devices connected here. Okay, I'll just restart this. Well, it is taking more time to respond. So now you know the procedure on how to create a graph. So you can create a reports of data published for all the devices whichever you need. Okay, now coming to the instant command. Now you want to select you have to send a command to a specific device. Okay, so here using the topic name you can access a specific device. Now for example, if I'm taking say room temperature here, room temperature level, now whatever the command I'm sending here will go to the subscriber. Right, so subscriber will publish it. Okay, so now same way if I take metal detect level, then also the subscriber will publish. Right, now if I take a room temperature and you send a command, specific command, okay, it will go to the subscriber. Right, so it means that the subscriber is connected to the broker and the topic communication will happen through the subscriber. Right, now suppose if I write a command data for room temperature level, okay, so this is message from broker, so it will go to the subscriber. Okay, now how to see, you have to see the device log of subscriber. If you open a device log of subscriber, So there you can see the message will be sent to the publisher, and publisher will subscriber, and subscriber will publish that particular message. Means who is sending a data here? A publisher, a broker is sending a data, right? Now this command can also be suppose you want to stop a specific device, then you can design command such a way that you can stop that particular device. Or if you want to pause it, okay? So, or if you want to turn on a specific thing, then you can send that specific command through this option, okay? So, it means that the broker is controlling the devices here, okay? Through this option. Now, coming to the rule engine. So, in rule engine, here suppose the broker has to create some alert. Okay. So now the subscriber was creating the alert. Suppose the broker has to create some alert, or the broker, depending on the value observation in the devices, if it has to send a message or if it has to send a mail to the specific user. So here you can create in a rule engine, you can specify a rule. Okay. So if for a particular device here, so I'll write temp underscore s. So if it is publishing, I should know what is a topic name. Okay. Okay. So copy the topic name for the particular temperature sensor. Okay. So room temperature slash level, okay, is the topic name. So I should know the topic name to create this. So published from temp underscore s, okay, room slash temperature slash level, okay, is the topic name. And here you give a condition. Means when the condition is satisfied, the event will be executed. Okay, so this is called as rule based event. You can also implement rule based event. Okay, suppose if the room temperature level is or greater than specific value, say I will give room temperature is greater than 10, okay, or say greater than 50, so it will create an alert. Now what alert it has to do? So you want to alert the device, then you can give a device name and a message here, or you want to send an email alert, then you can configure an email alert here. So you can configure a mail ID here. So when this particular condition is true, it will send a mail. Okay, so temperature alert, then so this is from broker, temperature alert. Okay. So now you can add as many conditions you want and as many events you rule-based events you want for a specific device. Okay, now I have configured say the email alert for the temperature data. Okay, so I can also give an email alert to a device instead of sending a mail. Okay, so this is room slash temperature slash level. Okay, so give a condition. So say less than, I'll give for less than. So less than, I'll give 40 here. So you can give multiple conditions for a particular event. Okay, so suppose I want to give a here both room temperature and say in a specific time. Okay, so both the condition has to satisfy, or if the device ID equal to temp underscore s. Okay, so here when device ID is temp underscore s and the value room temperature value is 40, then it will create the event, it will execute the event. Okay, so I have to send a message to the say device here, temperature slash level. Okay, so this is temperature alert. I'll just write low temperature from broker. Low temperature and message from broker. Okay, so I have saved this. So to see this, you have to go to the device log. Okay, so you have to observe the device log, then you will come to know whether the event is executed, event is created or not. Okay, see, now you got a message. Now it's a temperature sensor, right? So I had given if the value is less than 40, so it is to receive a message, temperature, low temperature broker. Okay, means the broker is sending that the temperature is low. Okay, because the value is less than 40, the condition was true and it has created the alert. The rule based event is executed here. Okay, so this is about the minimum configuration. Okay, so we can do using the IoT simulator. I'll show you the email alert. So here I've so when that specific thing happens, say if the temperature is high and you have to create an email alert, so you can do that. Okay, so here the temperature alert message, right? So now you can see the room temperature level. So this particular, the value is 63. At given if the value is more than 50, it has to create an email alert, right? So the value was 63 and it has created the email alert. Okay, so this is this will be alert will be created and given to the subscriber, and subscriber will send the alerts, okay, to the specific device or the user. So this is how you can even simulate the user alerts, okay, based on the published data. Right, so this is about the minimum configuration or the steps, okay, in order to simulate a very basic IoT circuit or an IoT system. So before I go to the next topic, I would like to take questions, if any questions.
There is only one question, ma'am. I'll just read it out.
Yeah.
Is there any limitation in number of emails per day?
No, there is no limitation as such. Okay, for any number of alerts, it will send any number of emails. Okay, so now you can see I already received 6 emails, right, for the data. Okay, there is no limitation. Okay. Then yesterday there was a question. Suppose you have a temperature sensor, right, with the same configuration, and you have to create n number of temperature sensors, right? Means the device with the same configuration, if you create a sensor or a device with the same configuration, more in here called as a template option. Now go to the option here, click on the templates. Okay, now if when you open for the first time, you will have already a predefined template here. Okay, this is a free version which I'm using. So in free version, you can create only one template. There is some limitation. Okay, so what you have to do is delete the existing the default template, and you can create your own template. Okay, so now I click on create template here, write the template name, say I want temperature sensor. Okay, so give a template ID. So I'll give a SPS. So you can write this is a group of temperature sensors. Okay, so now create it. So, okay, I have to give a different name. for this because I have already given this name. Fine. Okay. So now you create an events here. Okay. So you create an event. Suppose say I want on connect event. Okay. So temperature underscore connect. So you can give a message. Save it. So you need to wait for some time because sometimes it takes time to update the simulator. Respond. Okay, so your temperature connect event is created. Refresh the network. Okay, so once you create this template, you go to the device new device option. There you can select a device from the template. Okay, so now say here three devices added, right? Three devices already there. Now I've created a template. Now I want to go for a add device. Okay, to add device, you click on plus. Now you have device from template. So here the template will be listed out. Now T underscore S was the idea I had given for a temperature sensor, right? Now say you want to add 5 temperature sensor or 50 temperature sensors. Okay, so here you can mention the number, how many device you can add, and you can enter a prefix name. This will act like a device ID for each temperature sensors. Okay, so I click on the create. Now you can see the 5 devices are added. Okay, these 5 devices are of same type with the same configuration. Right. So now same way you give the authentication to the broker and connect to the broker. So then it will start publishing the data. Okay. So this is how you can add n number of devices with the same configuration, similar device with the same configuration. Okay. So now let us take up. I have created a network here, IoT network, which the broker is Babyvice IoT platform, right? Now I'll demonstrate how to connect it to the Azure IoT platform. Means it's not only to the Babyvice, you can connect to any other broker also. Even you want to create a local host broker, that is also possible in this simulator. Okay, so you don't have to connect to the any cloud-based or any commercial IoT platform, right? If you want a local host broker, you can download Babyvice local host broker and you can install that. So within the local system also, you can simulate your network. Okay, so that option is there. Now I'll just show how to connect to the so I'll stop this network. So I'll create a new network. So this is how to connect to the Azure platform. Okay. Azure platform. Click on create. Right now what you have to do is in the broker settings you choose Azure underscore IoT. Okay, now the broker IP address is same as device manager dot Babyvice. So you can directly connect to the Azure broker, or now what is happening, Yeah, BabyWise is providing a platform wherein it can connect to other brokers also, right? So it means that through the BabyWise broker, you're connecting to the Azure broker, right? So that's why the broker IP address is BabyWise only, but internally the working, this broker in turn connects to the Azure platform, right? Now, for Azure, TSL, SSL is enabled, okay? And you can see the broker port is changed to 883, right? Suppose if you are using, see here only Azure AWS is listed out. Suppose if you are using any other IoT platform, and how to know the broker port of that particular broker. Now, if you go to the, say, the AWS platform, or if you search for broker port of, Azure IoT platform, okay? So, we will get in the specific website, they will publish this information, okay? So if you want to use a web socket, then you, the port number is 443. So if you go to the web page of that particular broker, so there you will come to know what is the port. See, MQTT port is 883, okay? If you want to enable a web socket, then the, you have to use a port 443. Okay, so accordingly, you can provide an a broker port number here, right? So if you want to know what is an Azure platform port, you just search for AWS IoT platform. So if you go to that particular website, they will mention what is a port. So for Azure, for client authentication, you'll be using port number as 443. Okay. So whichever broker you are using, go to that particular page. So there they will give you the specification of whether the it is based on TLS or whether what is the port number. Okay. Sometimes even you can download their root certificate also and upload here. Okay. So it depends on the platform you are going to use. Now, because for Azure, SSL is activated, I have to upload the root certificate here. Right. So in the previous network, it was BabyWise platform I was using. I didn't do any root authentication, or I was not using any SSL security there. Right. So here, because I'm using Azure, so it has enabled SSL, I have to upload the root certificate. Now, where to find the root certificate? You go to the folder where BabyWise is installed. Okay. So, BabyWise IoT Simulator, you have a folder called as certificate, right? So, here in root, you choose the root security certificate, okay? Because I'm connecting to the BabyWise broker itself, via this I'm, say, accessing Azure IoT, right? So, I'm uploading the root certificate of BabyWise. Suppose if you want to directly connect to the Azure IoT, then you have to download the root certificate of Azure broker, okay? So, and then you have to upload here. So, click on upload, then clean session, give a clean session so that you don't want any data to be saved on the Azure. So, enable clean session as 1, okay? So, here you can do the advanced settings depending on the number of devices you are going to use, okay? So, I click on save. Right, so all other steps are same as what we have done yesterday, right? So add a device, okay, add a blank device. So you can use say image sensor. This is this. Right. So now use the same authentication. Go to the broker security. Get the authentication here. So you can also create your own authentication. See here, SAS and self sign. Okay. Because we have suppose if you have your own digital signature, that also you can upload here. Okay. The for the device. So SS token, we are using a root certificate and SSL layer. So the token is automatically generated here for this device, right? So that token will be taken. This is an additional security you are providing. Click on save. Then give a token here. Okay. So now you can switch on this network. Okay. So go to devices and see it is active. Right. So you can click on this. So here the activity, what is the activity it has performed? It has performed connect activity, right? I have not created any event so far for this device. So it is not showing any other event. Only event it has performed is it is connected to the network. Okay. So suppose I create some event here, say on connect, image connect. Sensor connected. Okay. Then write a full day event. Topic image data. So I'll go for a JSON construct because I need an array to write an image data. Okay. So I'll use image data. Okay, here you can select an array because the array, right? You can even create an nested JSON. So I create one more array here. Okay, so add array here, right? So now you can see here the array within the array, right? So it is creating the nested JSON here. You can give some value. Okay, click on save. Right, now two events are created here. Now let us see. Now you can see the event is executed. Okay, so you can see the activity of the device. And any command you are sending, right, so that you will come to know here whether the command is sent or not. Any events received by the device, you will come to know here. So whether even the publisher also can be a subscriber, okay? So the publisher can also be a subscriber. In that way, whether the publisher has subscribed to any topic, okay? So that details you'll come to know. So any rule you have defined, that data you'll come to know here, okay? So now whatever the communication happening here, it is via Azure IoT platform. Okay, so any questions?
Yes, ma'am, I'll just send it to you now.
Is there any possibility to make communication between simulator to gateway connection for bringing the data outside simulator? You can do that because we have a Python interceptor option, right? So there you can customize the simulator. So if you are not finding any option in the default option, so you can write your code and you can enable it. You can do that. So can we get alert to the mobile? How? As of now, that option is not there. Again, you can create a mobile phone alert using the code. Okay, all you need to do is yesterday I was showing in the Python interceptor, right? Now, for example, if you go to this folder, say extension folder, so here you have a default interceptor. So if you write a Python code here, you can customize here, you can add your own options here if it is not available in the default option. So write a code here. So whenever your network is up, this particular code will be executed. Okay, if you want to create a mobile alert, you can write a code here. And to connect to the gateway, because we have APIs, I'll show you that APIs also. So you can use that APIs and you can write a code here and it will be executed. Is there text message or WhatsApp message possibility with this simulator? I think I answered this question. You can customize by writing your own code. The default option given here is you can send a message to the device or you can send a alert message via email. Okay, we have only those options as of now. So anyway, you can customize it using this Python code. Or you can make use of an API. Already APIs are available, supported. So use that API and write a code. Okay, so this is about the the options in order to simulate any given IoT network. Now I'll show you some more things in this simulator. As I was talking about, we have an API. Okay, so go to the BabyWise web page. So so go to the developer support. So here you have an API documentation, right? So here you can see all the APIs supported, right? Now say you want to connect to the particular broker. Okay, you can write a code here. I was talking about you can connect to any broker you want, okay? So or any network you want. So in that case, you make use of this APIs, okay, in order to connect and start and stop the network. Okay, so you're asking about can you connect to the external gateway. Yes, you have used this API and you can connect to the gateway outside the simulator. Okay, so I'm not covering this part in the current webinar. API programming I'm not covering. Okay, so you can explore the option. You can explore this option. All right, so we have an API to configure to the network. And you can also create your own customized events. We have only 7 events supported readily in the simulator, right? We have only this set of events. So if you want to create your own event, you can make use of an event API. Okay, so here you can control the event, you can write a code, resume event. Okay, so you want to publish in a specific time with your own parameters, then you can customize here. And there are APIs for more error handling of the events. Okay, so that way you can write a code. Then we have publish API also. Okay, so you need to know what is the device ID, publishing ID, topic, message, right? So other than JSON data structure or construct, if you have to use any other data structure, then you can do it when you are using an APIs. Okay, so we have response API is available. Okay, now coming to the subscribe, so this API is for configuring and controlling the subscriber. So here we have a subscription details. Okay, you want to add a new subscriber, then you can use this API. Remove subscriber. Okay, unsubscribe. You want to unsubscribe all the devices, then you can use that. So get subscription details to retrieve the information about a particular device. Okay, so here what you can do is you can use the get subscription API. So then you can define your own rules and create the alerts. Okay, so here you can customize your code. Yes, so any more questions?
Yes, ma'am, I will send it to you.
So some cloud offers Excel file with the data like this, any backup available. If you're talking about the device log, yes, we can do that. But right now, I've not got a complete access to that broker setting because I'm using an free version. So I've not got a complete broker rights. Okay, a complete not demonstrate, but if you go for a premier version of the simulator, then you will get all the options where log, everything can be downloaded as an Excel sheet. Right now, you can add widgets here, like you can design your dashboard. I'll click on plus and design. You can design your dashboard. So you want to display some, okay? So you can do that. I'll just show you those options. Now what we have is, okay, I'll stop this network. I'll go to the previous one, click on existing. So this, okay. Let it open. Temperature sensor data. So now it is temp_s device ID. This data will be displayed on the dashboard in the form of a text. Okay. So here you can mention key or message integer. So any unit you want to specify, you can specify here. So maximum minimum values you can write. Okay, we don't need any other. Click on create. So now you can see the data okay will be displayed like this. Now the LED light will be on. Okay, so that also you can do. You can view your data in the form of an LED status, right? So I'll give for proximity. So you can say when the topic C, when this particular proximity sensor is disconnected, then you can make an active or an inactive status. Okay. So suppose metal detect level is there, you can specify when this value is active. Okay. So it should show the LED in the say green color. Okay. Suppose if the value is 10, it should show in green color. If the value is say some 15, it will show in the red color. Okay, like this you can make LED. Or say when the sensor is disconnected, then the LED should show with the specific color. That also you can do it here. So key is message integer. Okay, now it will turn it when it connects. Say I will turn the LED into blue, right? Right now it is red in color. So let me start this network. So it is giving an error because I have not set an authentication key for few devices here. Okay. So the moment it connects, it is turned to blue and then it will come back to the original position. Now you can see the temperature data sensor data is changing here. Okay. So even you can add a switch. Okay. Now say health taken subscriber or say same proxy. Second. Then underscore s. So I'll take for subscriber. Okay, subscriber. Say will subscribe. Subscribe to topic, right? So if it is active, sensing the data and publishing it to the network. So in this case study, I have three publisher and there is one subscriber who wants to take this data, right? So that is a remote server, right? So remote server take a data from the sensors and all the analytic logic. I will do some analytics on the basic analytics at the broker side. And if I want my own analysis on the data, then I publish a site. Okay. So, the subscriber side. So, this particular remote server is acting like a subscriber here. Then I have to create an, say, alerts. And you know already know how to create an alert. You want to generate an email alert, you can do. Or you want to create an LED alert, that also you can do using the simulator. Right. So, you generate a specific alerts here. Now what is the work of broker here in this case? So the published data has to be routed to the subscriber. That's all I want, because I do all other analytics at the subscriber side. Okay, so then the broker work is to connect these devices, to interconnect these devices, right? Now sensors, the value will be in the form of an voltage. Okay, the output of the sensor will be in the form of an voltage. This voltage ranges from 2 to 20 volts. Okay, so this is what I have understood. Now, when I'm simulating this proximity sensor, so I simulate the value of sensor within a range of 2 to 20 volts. Okay, now same way for ENOS, okay, electronic nose or olfactory sensor. If carbon dioxide is there, okay, so it will give you the value between 0 to 1000, right? If ENOS is sensor is giving you the value between 1000 to 2000, means it is NO2. So, like this, how I got these values 0 to 1000, 1000 to 2000 by referring to the literatures. And if you go through the commercial, the sensor specification, they will give you the complete manual about the sensor. So read all those things and find what is the value even in which particular case. Okay, do this homework. Now, coming to the camera, so we know that the camera sends the data, right? And it will be in the form of an two-dimensional array, right? So I can take a random values for array and then I can say simulate the camera values, right? So this is how you have to do lots of homework before you start the simulation, right? So now we know who are the publisher, we know who is the subscriber, we know the broker, and we know what data these publishers will publish under different circumstances, right? So with this much information, you can start designing your simulation. Okay, so go to new network. stop this network. Okay, I'll take a new network. So, network IoT, this is IoT network for airport surveillance. So I'm creating airport IoT. So do the broker settings as usual, right? So I don't want to change anything. I will retain all the default settings here. Click on save. Yes. So broker settings is done. Now device. I need how many publishers? 3 publishers. 1 subscriber. So I need 4 devices here. So I'll take a say 4 device. So first device, proximity sensor. So I'll write A_P for proximity. I'm just repeating the entire step with the specific case study. Okay, those who missed yesterday, so you can follow this step. So blank device. I need one more device, that is a camera. Okay, so I write it as an image sensor. A cam. So third device, I need a e-nose. Click on save. Okay, so 3 publisher device is created and I need 1 subscriber. So I plan device. So I'll write remote PC. Remote PC. So I write a subscriber. Remote subscriber. So now the device is ready. Okay, devices are ready. I have 4 devices. The next step is you have to create an event for these devices. Okay, so I'll take proximity sensor. So yeah, it is up to you. You have to create an on connect or on disconnect event. Okay, if you want to monitor like when the sensor is connected or disconnected, so then you can define this particular event. Okay, so proxy connect. Connected. So a simple text message is enough for this, so I'm creating only text message. Disconnect. Now coming to you can write it for a specific time or you can create an whole day event. So because it's an airport environment, the surveillance is required for the entire day. I'm creating an whole day event. So you can select the into a layer every 10 seconds. So what I need is a pouch, metal, or object, detection level. Okay, so I want to create, you can go for a text message because we know that proximity sensors will give a value ranging from 2 volts to 20 volts. Okay, so give 2 volts to 7:30 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. That is for 7:30 p.m. Write image data. Okay, so now here, image is an array. In a message, we have a limitation, right? We cannot create an array here. So now go for a JSON. Okay, later you choose the message type. If your data is a simple value or simple message, you can go for the text message type. Or if it is a complex data, then you can go for the JSON construct. So if you are using a Python interceptor, you can go for the other data structure also if you are going for the coding. So here I'll choose, I need array, and write again image data. So to give a value for an image, I choose a random value. Okay. Take an array, and inside this you can choose a random value. Take random value. Okay, click on add. So I've created with the random array data. So event I've created for the image sensor. Right? So olfactory sensor, coming to the next one. The olfactory sensor, what is the value I need? Olfactory sensor, as per my analysis, say if I have to monitor CO2 level and NO2 level, for CO2 I have 0 to 1000 and 1000 to 2000. See, 2000 for NO2, right? So here I'll give, again create on connect event. Connected. Image disconnected. Okay, so to event. Now I have to create an event. Say whole day event. Every 10 seconds or every say 20 seconds you can create. Now I have to look for an CO2 level. Okay, so I create a event for CO2 level. Okay, so here I can do the task with simple JSON because it is a range of value between 0 to 1000. So choose a range, give 0 to upper value is 1000. Okay, so 0 to 1000. Click on save. Now I've created an event for detecting the CO2 level, right? Now same way, create it for NO2 level. Create one more event for NO2 level. Now the topic here, airport. Now I want NO2 level, so I'm creating one more topic. So now for this, the sensor will give a value from 1000 to 2000. So for overlapping values and all, you have to control it in the code or at the subscriber end. Okay, you have to write a logic for that. So you can see that if the topic, say topic name, airport NO2 level, then the value if you are getting as 1000, then it is corresponding to the NO2 level. Or if the topic airport CO2 level and the value is 1000, then it is corresponding to the CO2. Okay, so using a topic, you can separate the duplicate values. Right, now click on save. So for eNotes, I've created an NO2 topic and CO2 topic, both the topics. Right, now coming to the subscriber. So this is remote PC connect. Post is up. Remote PC disconnect. So remote host is down. Now subscribe to the topic. Now I need to know the topic names, right? So proxy. So there are three topic, but I need only the airport object level value at the remote PC. Say for remote PC, it may not be, I may not want to monitor whether the sensor is connected or not. That is not of my interest as a remote subscriber. Okay, so as a subscriber, what I need is a sensor data. So I will subscribe only to that particular topic, right? So who has to monitor the device status? Broker has to monitor. So broker will make use of connect and disconnect topic. Subscriber will make use of a specific topic. Okay, so you subscribe to the specific topic which is required, not for all the topic. Now remote PC gets subscribed to only one topic, that is object level, right? So the proximity sensor data it can receive. Now coming to the image sensor, here also we have three events or three topics, but remote PC is interested only in the image data, right? So remote PC may not want the status of the camera, right? That status of camera, whether camera is continuously on or off, should be taken by the device manager. So what is the work of remote PC? If it is only data analysis, then they don't want as connection or disconnection status of the publisher, right? So no need to subscribe for that particular topic. So now subscribe for image data topic. Then for olfactory sensors, airport CO2 level. So it will subscribe only for CO2 level. Okay, so then we have one more, MO2 level. So it will subscribe for MO2 level. Okay, so CO2 level and MO2 level. So this subscriber is subscribed to four topics where it can receive the proximity data, image sensor data, that is camera data, and it can receive a data for CO2 level and NO2 level, right? Now, what to do with these data, it should be decided at the remote PC end. Okay, there you can, go for a default option by using a behavior event, or you can write your own code, what to do with the data, what kind of analysis you need to do with this data. Okay, so I'm not adding behavior event. Now the topic is NO2 level. Now what is a command data? Suppose if it is going beyond 2000, right? The upper limit is 2000. If it is going beyond 2000, then create an NO2 alert. So what is the data? Beyond range. Can write it as beyond range. Okay. So like this, for all the four topics, you can create the behavior alert. So now our subscriber and publishers are ready. Just check with the broker setting. So broker setting is okay. Now authentication. Okay. So go to the device manager. Go to security. Now provide an authentication to these devices. So I'll take remote PC, enable the authentication, provide access key, save. Next, authorization token. Give token here, save. Now I've given authentication to the remote PC. Same way, give it for olfactory sensor. So take authentication key. Okay, so for image sensor, authentication token. Okay, so next for same way for proximity. So the simulation of airport surveillance network is ready now. Okay, so with whatever the things I've defined here, right? So proximity sensor available, image sensor available, Neo's available, remote PC is available, and the broker is also available at your level. Okay, so by creating your own dashboard, or you go to this dashboard, if you want, you can remove this previous one. Okay, so I'll remove all these previous ones. So now I'll create an LED here. So LED say once one for proximity and one for Neo's I will create. So I have to switch on the network, then only I will get those devices. Okay, so now authentication is ready. Switch on your network. Right, now network is on. Now see, so see the active devices. Yes, all four devices are up. Okay, so you can go to the dashboard. Here you can see all devices log here. So orange corresponding to the subscriber and green corresponding to the publisher's data. Okay, so when the device is on, say you're getting proximity connected, camera is on, and Enos is connected. Okay, so here now subscriber is also connected, right? And so like this, you can check the log of the devices. This is at the simulator end. Same thing you can do at the say device manager at the broker level also. So now you can monitor this data. Okay, so next. Enos data you want to monitor. So now you can monitor the Enos data here. Right, so this is at the broker, okay, at the broker level, right? Now here you can create an email alert. As I mentioned, suppose if the camera is disconnected, okay, then you can create an email alert for that. I'll just show, delete all the existing alert. Okay, I need to know the disconnection status. So the topic is camera disconnect. When this event happens, I have to create an alert. Okay, so the device is camera connection. So new device ID. Create them. Topic is camera disconnection. Okay, so you may skip the condition also. You may, if you don't want to give the condition, you may skip the condition also. Okay, no need to give this. So here mail ID. Here the mail ID and create camera status. So basically, suppose you want to write camera one is disconnected. Disconnected. Immediate action required. Then type a message there. Click on save. Okay. Now what I do is I disconnect the image sensor. Now camera is off, right? We need to wait for some time to receive the alert. It takes time. Okay, like this, you can also simulate your own design, your own project like this using Fairywise. Okay, so that's all I wanted to discuss in this particular webinar. So if you have any questions, you can ask.
No, ma'am, there are no questions in the chat box.
Okay, so thank you all for giving me this opportunity to share information about the Fairywise network. So thank you, my team and the organizing committee.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Ma'am?
Okay.
Thank you very much for accepting our invitation for our International Faculty Development Program, ma'am. These 3 days, your session was very informative. I am sure, ma'am, it will be useful for all the faculty, research scholars, students, ma'am. Once again, thank you very much, ma'am. And we also received very good feedback last 3 days from participants, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all. Thank you.